two main factors. The first one is the UK business market was much stronger than expected, so we're really pleased with that, and across all sectors. And also the return of the North American market, which didn't really come to Europe last year as much as usual, but I guess the weak sterling enticed them to come and visit Europe.
And have you been pushing Eurostar quite aggressively to the US market at the moment?
Yeah, we're advertising over there. We've just launched our new website. It's a big market for us, and at the moment it's working very well. So fingers crossed for the rest of the year.
Now, clearly during the last few months, sterling has recovered somewhat against the euro. Has that put a spring in the step of British travellers again?
There are different dynamics there at work, because even if there is a weaker pound compared to the euro, say, the UK traveller, first of all, people want to protect their holidays. And then maybe instead of going to New York for 4 days, well, they will go to Paris for 4 days. So we haven't seen any weakening of demand on the UK side. On the contrary, it's quite a good market at the moment. The May bank holiday was very busy, it's very, very positive. So hopefully the summer will be good.
What's really interesting is that you're seeing quite a pickup in business travel to Brussels. Is that British businessmen trying to get their position in order ahead of Brexit?
It might be a mixture of everything. I think in general, the economy is still, there is confidence in the UK, but also the French market is doing very well. The economy is recovering quite quickly. So I think there are a lot of exchanges between the two cities at the moment. It's very, very, very good.
What was your reaction to the French election?
I'm very happy, very happy. I think Emmanuel Macron is a very good president. He has a strong mandate with 66% of the votes. It was a long campaign, so it was nice to have it come to a close. And he's pro-business, he's optimistic, he's got good views about what he wants to do. So hopefully it will be good for France and hence for the UK and Europe.
And so a strong recovery in French GDP growth would really be quite meaningful for Eurostar's bottom line then?
It's always good. We prefer to rely on strong economies, and it would mean a lot to us. And actually, at the moment, we see both the London economy and the Paris economy are doing very well, and we can see that in our numbers.
Now, one of the big events for you this year is going to be direct routes between London and Amsterdam. Are you any nearer to announcing when you're going to launch those?
Yeah, we are nearer, but we can't tell exactly. It will be before the end of the year, but we have a first step, which is we're going to launch our new trains to go to Brussels from London in a couple of weeks. So that's a big event. We've invested a lot of money into the Brussels station to welcome our trains. And then the step after will be Amsterdam and Rotterdam. And we are very excited.
And what sort of market share do you think you can capture in fairly short order?
Oh, it's stable in terms of market share. It's very competitive at the moment. But on the Amsterdam route, we would expect to gain market share, of course, against the airlines. So that's our way to growth, in a way. I think what we'll do as well is we'll grow the market. We'll take some share from the airlines, but what we know from experience is that a lot of people will say, oh, there's Eurostar, I'm going to try it. And so we hope to grow the market.